Welcome to Whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning. I'm the master taster of Whisky.com. And today I have a Oban Distillers Edition here in my cask. It's vintage 2018, distilled in 2004. It's 43% ABV and it's priced, well, a little higher than the typical Oban 14 years. And Oban is one of the classic malts of Scotland, which were established in 1988. There are six of them, and Oban is the least often sold of those six whiskies. So this one is a smaller distillery with a little output, only two stills, if I remember right. And I like the distillery very much from the optical view, from the taste as well. When you come from Isla or from Mull with a ferry into the harbor of Oban, then you see the distillery close to the harbor with their old gray granite stone warehouses and the chimney. And on top of everything is the old, well, monument from the war. So it's an impressive view in the harbor. And yeah, the distillery is there since 1794. It's a very old one from the 18th century. And I think it's there because the ban of not being allowed to produce malt whiskey was only in the Highlands. And Oban belonged to the coastal region and probably belonged to the, well, the Lord of the Isles. I'm not quite firm in that historic matter, but that might be a reason why the distillery was allowed to work, and it was easily reachable by boat, so the tax exchequer was able to inspect everything. Yeah, the Oban is typically 14 years of age, 43% ABV for all Obans, as well as this one, and this is 14 years as well, and finished in Montilla Fino sherry casks. What's that? Well, that's a non-oxidized sherry. On the top of the sherry in the cask, there's the yeast, the foam of the yeast, and it's that thick that there's no oxygen going through into the wine, and the wine is not oxidized and keeps lighter, and it keeps drier. Well, that's belongs as well to the grapes used. But the Fino sherry typically is a dry sherry. This is that. Every year there's a new vintage coming out from Oban. So this one is 2018. And I looked my old videos up and I had a video from the year 2000 where I tasted I think it was in 1998, distillery edition. The distillery edition came out a little later than the typical classic malt of Scotland. I think some 8 or 10 years after the establishment of the classic malts of Scotland. Typically, you use the normal Oban and select the cask which haven't matured that intense, and then you move them over to the finishing casks and add some, well, Fino sherry notes to this whiskey so that it adds up to an equally intense whiskey as the normal 14 years of age is. Very complex. A little bit of smoke, but I don't think that's smoke. That's some, well, charred oak from the casks. There's a lot of grape and orange peel. A lot of fruitiness, maritime seaweed. No sharpness at all. Officially it said it's sharp on the nose. No, it's not. I think it's a little sharper on the taste, and the smoke is no real smoke. The distillery is located in between the Highlands and the with the Speyside and the islands, the Inner Hebridean islands, and as well as the taste, this light, fruity, malty character of the Highlands and the Speyside isn't in this one, but the extreme smokiness from Islay and other distilleries on the islands isn't there as well. So this is a complex, a complete own tastes developed in this Oban, showing, well, a coastal influence, I would say. And it's complex, full, and this grapes and orange peel is always there. Yeah. Oops, first time I got a drop on the back of my tongue. Yeah, managed to swallow, not to cough. And there's a full oaky character in my mouth, intense. And now a little maltiness and sweetness appears. And in the aftertaste, definitely oak and probably a hint of coffee. Not too strong, not too bitter. And it's becoming drier, really. So the Fino Sherry shows the grapes and a little dryness. And it's, well, it's fits the original character of the Oban from this coastal sea shore smell very well and gives a complete different single malt as we typically have in that region. Very pleasant, very interesting, very good. Yeah. Oakiness, a little spiciness coming up, becoming drier. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So this one is a good companion to the typical Oban 14 years of age, and yeah, it's a definite buy for this one because it's so, yeah, drier and more dry fruitiness than others have. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned, there's more to come, and hopefully in a few years we will taste the 2020 or 2022. So in the upcoming years, this description will fit more or less to the next vintages coming out. The number of casks are, well, they are not too small, and the type of finishing and type of wood is comparable. So the results from year to year are comparable, but they are not equal. So this is a hint how the next and the one after the next will taste, really. Might taste. Oh, difficult. Yeah. Thank you very much for watching. Stay tuned. There's more to come, as always.